Welcome to SagaFast Techniques. Today I'll show you how to do a popular fox on fabric technique. You can do fox on fabric horizontally or vertically, and I'm going to show you both. Please feel free to follow the link to download the manual for this technique. For the horizontal fox on fabric, I'm going to use fin raccoon. You can use both long and short hair first, but keep in mind that the shorter the hairs, the more striped the look. I'm going to take this woven fabric and mark my lines. For this hair length, we recommend 2.5 centimeters between the lines. I'm using masking tape, but you can easily draw on the lines if you prefer. I've cut the fin raccoon into 4 millimeter wide strips, brushed them and put them in order on a board. Start with the bottom strip. I'm using a zigzag stitch. If you're unsure about what type of stitch to use, please watch basic fur skill video, Sewing Household Machine. Now just keep on going from the bottom to the top. For the vertical fox on fabric, I'm using Arctic Marble Frost Fox. It has a great hair length for this technique. The vertical fox on fabric is ideal for both woven and stretch fabrics. I'm using stretch. I've chosen a striped jersey, which means I don't have to mark the lines. If you're using plain jersey, just mark the lines as shown before. On the vertical fox on fabric, we want the gap between the lines to be a maximum of 1 centimeter. I've cut the Arctic Marble Frost Fox in 4 millimeter wide strips. I've brushed them and put them in order on a board. I'm starting with the strip to the right, and I'm starting on the left side of the fabric. I'm using a zigzag stitch because this is stretch fabric. Be careful not to stretch the fabric while sewing. Now just keep going from left to right. Now look at these amazing light samples we've created. These are so easily made into jackets or even cardigans. I hope you had great fun and got inspired by watching SagaFast Techniques. For more fabric-based techniques, please watch technique videos, tiles, and finish. Enjoy!